Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. I'm trying something a little different. I've changed some makeup around and I am going to film a tutorial and I've moved some stuff around, so we're going to see how it goes. I think I have you on focus, so I'm going to put my little kitty cat ears on. I have my hair up in a ponytail. I've been up cleaning and doing some stuff and I thought, I need a tutorial. And it's 2:25 to 2 a.m. on Tuesday night, early Wednesday morning. So we're going to try something a little different today, okay? I put Simple Moisturizer on earlier when I cleaned my face and I thought I was going to bed. I can't sleep. So first I'm going to go in with this Pixie Milky Mist. And douse my face in it because my face is extremely dry. And I'm going to go in with a good, an oldie but a goodie. I'll shake it up. I ain't used it in a while. I've rearranged some of my drawers and I've cleaned out my condenser with all my scrapbook and stuff and I've put makeup in them and I had to expand my drawers. I'm going in with the Nivea Men Sensitive Post Shave Balm. I don't know how this is going to work. I don't have a table in front of me. I got my stuff to the side and I'm just going to work off the table. So, and I'm going to use the viewfinder. So we're going to see how this works. This may be a blowout. This may not work at all. If you're sensitive to smells, this does have a smell when you first put it on. It smells like a man, well, it says man shaving balm. So it's after they shave, they put this on. But Nikki Tutorial swears by it. It's got extremely high glycerin, which is sticky. It makes your skin tacky. So, it does really well. I've got some music going. I hope YouTube don't kick the video for it. We'll see. We'll just have to play it by ear. I don't know how this is going to work. I just thought I'd try something different. Next, I'm going to go in, and I'm not doing my face yet. I'm going to do my eyes first. I've been watching a lot of videos, and I'm going to move you guys up a little bit. I've been watching a lot of videos, and it seems like the YouTubers are doing eyes before makeup. So, we're going to check that out. And what did I do with my scotch tape? Casey Holmes does this, and we're going to try it. I don't know how well it'll work, but you just take scotch tape, and you put it on the corner of your eye to where you don't want your eyeshadow to go any further on both sides. I think I got too much tape out, but like I said, this is something new. I'm going to try and see how well it works. I'm going in with my e.l.f. Primer, eye primer. And it's in clear. It's just a silicone. It looks just like the Smashbox I've been using. It's a good dupe. I think it's a good dupe if you're looking for an alternative, a drugstore alternative. And I just rub it between my fingers and then put it on my eyelids. I can't sleep. I don't know. It's Josh's first night back. He's been off since Saturday. And when he's off on them 3 days and I'm used to him being at home, I don't sleep. So it's just like, what do I do with myself? I'm going to the Kat Von D Shade and Light, and I'm going to pick up this shade right here, which is called, oh Lord's Heaven, L-E-V-I-T-A-T-I-O-N, girls, I ain't even going to try. And on a Morphe M441, I'm just going to lay the eye primer down. That's all I'm doing. I was gonna go get my nails done, and girls, I got into cleaning the walls and stuff, and I got into some kind of cleanser, and where my nails was so long because it had been like 3 weeks. For some reason they started cracking up around the sides and started lifting, and I just took them all off. So we're down to nasty nails. So don't look at that. Now, the reason I use that light shadow is because I made this kit one night when I was half asleep, half awake, and it's by Karity, C-A-R-I-T-Y, Professional. And you bought the kit, looks like this, and I done a haul on it when I first got it. And these are the colors I picked. Well, spring's around the corner, so I thought I'd do a spring eye look. So I'm going to go in, and these have names. I'm going to go in, and I'm going to do a blue-green eye. No, I'm going to do a purple-pink eye. So the first color I'm going to get is this one right here. I'm trying to get it without dropping it. And it is called Turkish Delight. It's an orangey-pinky color. And on the same brush, the M... 441. I'm going to go into the crease with that. And I'll put more on the end than I am on the inner. Okay? So the outer gets more than the inner. And that's going to be my crease shade or my transition shade. The reason I decided to tape is because, well, for one, I'm using some bright colors tonight. And I'm not for sure about them. So, we're just going to see. Okay, the next shade I'm going to go in with is going to be this fuchsia color. And girls, this was last year I ordered these. This is called Lexus. It's like an orchid color. I couldn't tell you how much I paid for it. And I'm going in with the E22 Morphe, of course. And I'm going to go below that. And again, I'm going to put more on the outer than the inner. But I'm still going to go into the crease, just a little bit below what I've done before with the Turkish Delight. And I want it on this eyelid on the outer. So, anyway, like I said, I don't know how much I paid for it. So, if you guys asked me, I couldn't tell you. Like I said, I was watching a tutorial, and they were talking about they were on sale. They had a really good clearance. They were good blendable shades. And I went on there and went ham. This is all I ordered. And this is the kit I made. And I was shocked when it came in. I was like, what was I thinking? Because... you guys know that is so not me. So not me. I'm going to go back in with a 441 with the Turkish Delight and just go and make sure that we don't lose that color. So I'm just going to blend them two in a little bit, which is a little bit of product. It's got a big mirror on it, which is nice. Yes, I'm in pajama bottoms. First video of mine wouldn't be a video unless I had to change batteries or had to move something. So anyway, this is the look you've got so far. And I was just getting ready to go in and make sure that I hadn't lost the color over here on this side. Now, I'm going to go in with a flat brush, and it's going to be the Morphe MB16. It's just a flat panel brush. And I'm going to pick up this light purple. And it is called, if I can get it up here, it looks like that, Zimba, Z-A-M-B-I, Zimba, and that's going to go on the eyelid. Now this does have a lot of fallout, girls, and guys, if there's any guys that watch, to me it's just makeup, I don't care. I watch guys all the time, Patrick Starr, Manny MUA. Who else do I follow? It's a guy. I got a couple of others that I just started following. So we're just going to put that all over the eyelid up into the crease. Then I'm going to pick up the 441. And just blend all that together. You start barking and I'm going to smack you. That ain't a thing in this house going. So that's what I got so far. Now I'm going to take my tape off and let's see how it's did. Nice clean line. Alright, let's see this side. Nice clean line. Okay, now with the panel brush, a smudge brush as I call it, this is the M213. This is an itty bitty brush. I'm going to do something a little crazy. It wouldn't be my channel if I didn't. And I'm going to go in with this greenish blue. I know y'all are thinking I'm crazy. It's called Bamba. B-A-M-B-A. Just like that. And I'm going to put that under my eyelashes on the bottom. And I didn't know what kind of look I was going for. I just knew I wanted a spring look. So, and I'm going to drag that out and kind of make a little bit of a wing from the bottom. And then pull it in to the top. And at the end of the day, end of the night, before I go to bed, it comes off. Because it's just makeup. So, why not? Right, guys? Okay. And then I'm going to take the E22, which was the purple. Orchid that we used to mix that in, and I'm gonna buff that back out just because I don't want to lose that color in that blue or that green. And then with the same smudger brush, I'm gonna pick up the first one, which is Turkish Delight, and I'm gonna go on the inner part of the eye and pull that in. That's pretty good. I like it. Okay, then back in with the green one. I was gonna do this tomorrow and then I thought, you know what? Josh works tomorrow night and it's kind of hard to make sure that I'm not being too loud in here. I mean, I know I'm on the other end of the house, but I know he definitely needs his sleep. I'm going to darken this green up on this side just a little bit more. Then I'm going to go back in with that E22 and that purple color. It's that second one that I used right there. And just make sure that I don't lose that on that end. Then I'm going back in with my paddle brush and I'm going to pick that purple back up. And just go back over my eyelids. And just deepen that in. Now I'm going to go back in that smudger brush, which is the E22. Nope. The MB13. No, the M213. I got too many brushes. Don't tell Josh I said that. And I'm going to put that on the inner part. Because you can never have too many brushes. That's just my opinion. Okay, now I didn't get a nude out eyeliner, but I'm going to grab it real quick. And I'm going to use the Little Rock Waterline Front of the Line Pro in nude. just like that. And I'm gonna put that in that water line. This is just gonna break up the color. And it's gonna make your eyes look more awake, which I'm definitely awake. Okay. And that's the eye look for now. We're not done. Okay. Now, I'm gonna use the NYX Total Control Dropper Foundation. And y'all know how I feel about this. So we're going to try to do it. Okay. It's a dropper. I've learned a little bit about it. I've been watching some tutorials. And been learning how to use this stuff just a little bit better because I like it. I like the coverage it gives. I dropped it on my shirt anyway. And guys, let me tell you, if you do that, it's harder than crap to get out. But I have a treat for you. Dawn dishwashing liquid. The blue. The plain blue. Spot clean it, it'll come right out. Okay. With my wet sponge here. And this is a Ulta sponge. It's just wet. We're going to start working that in. And I've said it a million times, if not a thousand times. We don't do dry because it just doesn't do the product. It just moves the product around. With the wet, it pushes the product into the face. And yes, I'm covering my lips. It's got really good coverage. I really do like this foundation. I just wish that, let me show you. And this is just a plain t-shirt. But I was getting ready one day, and I had my Lala Rue on, and I got it on my shirt. And I immediately freaked out, let me tell you. I'm going to pause y'all just a second. I did get it on my shirt, and I did freak out that day because I didn't know what to do to get it off. And I got out of a friend of mine that does Lala Rue. And she was like, what kind of foundation are you using? It's that good that it won't come out for the... You know, just water and a little bit of soap. And I told her, and she was like, D. She said the D word, which I don't cuss. So, now we're going to set, go ahead and set the face. No, we're not. We're going to do under eye. I'm going to use the NYX High Definition Concealer, and it is in CW01. If y'all hear the scanner in the background, I'm sorry. I meant to cut that off. And I forgot to do it. I'm gonna have to get me some more of this. I'm getting low. And with the same sponge, we're gonna go in and just pounce that in. But you don't have to use the same concealer that you use for your foundation. They don't have to match. Like name brand to name brand. You can use whatever you're comfortable with as far as that. Now I'm going to set my face, and I'm going to use this little pointer brush that I got from e.l.f. And this is an e.l.f. brush. It was $6 on their website. And I'm going to use my flare powder. If I can get it open. I love this thing. Cassie Helms uses it, and I thought, well, I'll get it and try it. And I love it. So we're going to use this pointy brush. And we're just going to pop it right on. We're going to go ahead and do the whole face. And this is a face brush, pointed brush. You can use it for whatever you want, but I need to make sure I'm not going to crease. Even though I'm probably going to finish this, edit it, and go to bed. Okay. Now that we got the whole face powdered, we can go on. I'm going to go into the Kat Von D light again. And I'm going to pick up this one right here, which is called Shadow Play. We're going to bronze with that. We're going to hit it right here in the corner. Both sides. We're going to go ahead and bronze up the forehead. I'm going to go ahead and get into the Tarte brush. It's just a flat brush. And I'm going to work in this a little bit better. There we go. See, it worked it in just a little bit more. Okay. So, it's got that done. Let's go ahead and highlight these bad boy cheeks. I'm going to use the Makeup Revolution Triple Bake Highlighter Goddess of Faith. I got this in a haul. I showed it in a haul. And I've got the e.l.f. Highlighting brush. It looks like this. Which, guys, you don't have to pick these brushes up. e.l.f.'s is cheap brushes. Not cheap product. Just cheap in price. And this is a pretty bronzer. This is the first time I've used this highlighter. Not bronzer, highlighter, I mean. This is a very pretty highlighter. So, how many of you have been watching the nice little giraffe? I'm going to put it on my, underneath and on top of my, I'm going to go across my eyebrows on doing, try and highlight that. And, take my finger, put it in the corner to highlight right there. In New York, April, who is pregnant with the giraffe, it's her fifth, and has not had it yet. But the news outlet went crazy, and everybody thought she was getting ready to have it, and has been watching it. I'm guilty. Okay, next time I'm going with Too Faced Better Than Sex mascara. I need a mirror. I need a mirror that I can hold. And we're going to roll these bad boys up. I like this mascara. It's a very good mascara. It lasts for a very long time. It curls your lashes a lot on its own too. That's what I like about it. I've ordered from Too Faced. I've got one order in. I'm waiting on my other order and I'm going to do a haul. I'm excited. First time I've ordered from Too Faced. I actually ordered from the website because I got a 20% discount. So I ordered from the website. Everything else I've gotten that's Too Faced I've gotten from either Poshmark and or Ulta. So I actually ordered from Too Faced. I got a really good deal. I got all kinds of goodies. I'll just have to show y'all when they come in. Okay. Next thing is my brows. And I didn't get my brow. Let me get my brow brush real quick. I'm using the Ulta's Palm Brow Pomade. I'm in medium brown. I'm going to be going in the next couple of days. Maybe just one day next week. I'm going to be getting my hair done. I think I'm going to go a little bit lighter. Since we're getting into the summer or winter, I mean spring months. I'm gonna dry my line and I put me in just a little bit of arch right there. And then I'm just gonna start going up and filling in from that line. Now you want it darker at the inner and lighter at the outer. But you want to make sure you get a tail there. And I don't put a lot on my brush. It's the reason you see me dip back into my pomade a lot. Is because I don't put a lot on my brush in the beginning. Because I don't want to mess it up. If y'all like comedy that's not child appropriate, but it's hilarious. I've been watching Trailer Park Boys. It's a British, it's filmed in Nova Scotia. Shannon XO and her husband, or her boyfriend or fiance, Hamish watches it. And they were talking about it one night. They had watched it on it. It's on Netflix. It is hilarious. There's a lot of pot on it. And you guys know I'm a Christian. But, you know, I don't have to answer to them. It's just funny to watch. It's something that, you know, brightens your day. But it's called Trailer Park Boys. It's hilarious. There's a movie. You need to watch the movie before you watch. It's called Trailer Park Boys, the movie. You need to watch it before you watch the seasons. And there's 10 seasons. 11th season is getting ready to come out on March 31st. I'm going in with the Benefit Gimme Brow in shade 3. And this has just got fibers in it and just makes you a little bit darker. And I just kind of, I do it kind of dark at the beginning and then kind of light in the middle and lighter at the end. And then I'm going in with Ulta's Clear Gel, which mine ain't clear no more. It's where I take it in and out of products so much, but I love this stuff. And we're going to go right that way and shape them bad boys. And you could go through a tornado and they will not move. Guaranteed. I've gotten pretty good at my eyebrows. At least I think I have. That's my eyebrows. So that's the eyes done. That's the face done. We got to put a blush on. Did I get a blush out? I didn't get a blush out. What was wrong with me? Oh no, where's my blushes? I don't remember where I put my blushes, guys. Okay. I found them. I got this off of Amazon. Amazon. It's called Music Flower. It's 5 color blushes. There's 5 different ones. I'm going to go in with this one right here. It's Barbie Pink. Well, apparently Barbie don't want to be used. Maddie thought it bubblegum pink, which it could be bubblegum pink. It looks like that. It looks like that. But it's 5 different blushes. I mean, it's got a peachy one, a lighter pink one, a brownish one. I had a sponge in it, and I tossed that as soon as I got it. There's an orange one, and then another little pinky one, and then the top one. So, I'm going to go in with this, the one I call Barbie, and she calls it bubblegum. And I'm going to go in with the Morphe M141, and this stuff is pigmented, and it's really pigmented. And it's not that expensive, guys. I mean, it's really, truly not. We're going to dab this on the cheek. Right underneath the bronzer. Right above the bronzer and underneath the highlighter. And I'm stippling it on just because it's so pigmented. And I don't want to take away from the eyes because of it being pink. Okay. Okay, so now, Smokey Bobby, that was Mama. What do I have left to do? My lipstick. Okay, I got Makeup Revolution's lip kits. They're called Retro Luxury Matte Lip Kit. The one I'm using is Grande. Grande. It's time for bed. It comes with a lipstick and then the lippy paint or the liquid lip gloss. And what I do, and this is a rock. is it a roll up? I can't remember if it's a roll up or if it's an actual pencil. It's a roll up. You have to roll up. No? That's not a roll up. It must be a sharpener. But anyway, we're going to outline the lips. Okay. Then we're going to take the liquid lipstick. And I love the packaging on it. This is the color it looks like. It's pretty. I'm doing pink. Can you tell I'm a pinky girl tonight? But anyway, there's Trailer Park Boys go to Europe. Trailer Park Boys go to Austin, Texas. Last but not least, I'm going to finish with the NYX Matte Finishing Spray and spray my face down. Now, that completes this look. This is just something I thought, you know, you could wear. I mean, it's wearable. You can do it lighter. You can go in with different color shades. You don't have to do the bottom. You can go with lighter pink. I mean, it's up to you. I just wanted to have fun. I was kind of in a fun mood. I've been dancing and goofing off and rearranging my makeup and doing this and that and the other. And I thought, you know what? I'm in such a good mood. I'm going to go ahead and film tonight because I may not feel like it in the morning. So I went ahead and film. I put a video up tonight. Today is the 28th. Well, I put it up on the 28th, which is Tuesday. I'm still uploading on Tuesdays and Thursdays. So it's up. It is, I think it's a Full Face Wet n Wild. And then Thursday is a collab with my niece. It is, the Bean Boozle Challenge, the 4th edition. Just Ann Ragnick. R-A-K-R-A-K-I-N on YouTube. Her and her daughter done it, and she sent me a message and said that would be cute for me and my niece to do it. So when we went to the grocery store on Saturday, we picked it up and we brought it home and we done it, and I got every one of the bad ones. I didn't get not one good one. So I tell Maddie it was rigged, and it was rigged in her favor because she knew which one to pick. I think she got two bad ones out of all of it, but it'll go up on Thursday. So day or night, wherever you are, guys, be safe, be careful. As always, I love each and every one of you. Thanks for staying with me and tuning in. Thanks for being my subscribers and loving me and caring for me and thinking about me and sending me sweet messages either on Facebook or on YouTube channel. Spread it around. If we don't get that 500 or at 100 by July 1st, then there won't be a giveaway. We'll just have to push it off like we did the other one. And so I reach what I want. But it's products. And you guys are going to be really happy with products. Some of the products I've used on. It's not products I've used. It's products I've gotten seconds of and used. So they're not used products. They're new products in packaging. But y'all see me use them. You like them. So yeah. I'm going to go and clean up my mess. Because I've got a mess. And the dog's over in the other chair at the computer desk asleep. I think he's saying, Mommy, it's time for bed. So you all have a wonderful morning. It's 10 after 2. I love you guys. Thanks for sticking with me. Thanks for being on the lily pad. If you notice in my next video, there's going to be a little bitty frog at the bottom of the screen. It's my watermark. And it's a female frog with eyelashes. It's really cute. So anyway, I love you guys once again. And I will talk to you in the next tutorial. Bye.